Welcome to the Jambox Show, Episode 6, Musical Instruments. I'm your host, Lee Evans. Lately, we've recorded a few different types of instruments here at the studio. Not those type of instruments. I'm talking about more common musical instruments. So today, we're going to do something different. We're not going to talk about how I recorded these instruments, but we're going to talk to the musicians that actually play these instruments and have them tell us a little bit about their special instruments. I'm also going to include a few examples of these instruments playing. Some of them are going to be phenomenal, so get ready. Stay tuned to the very end of this video for a very exciting impromptu performance from a very unique instrument. I think you're going to be impressed. But just a reminder, please support our show by liking this video, commenting below, and sharing with your friends. We're getting so close to 1,000 subscribers, I can smell it. What does it smell like? I don't know, but it smells a hell of a lot better than 900 subscribers. So please hit that subscribe button right below and remember to hit that little bell, ding, so you'll be alerted every time we release a new video. Our videos are going to be great. Hope you love them. We have in front of us the lovely
Jessica Stanley.
Okay, and Jessica, what is this big instrument that you have here in front of you?
This is called a tuba, and it's in the brass family of instruments. It is one of the largest instruments in the brass family. It usually plays the low notes and usually the bass line, just okay. What a bass would play.
That was playing the bass line before there was bass, right?
Exactly. Yeah. All right, so usually it plays low notes, but sometimes it also can play high notes. Yeah. But typically you will hear the low notes.
Could you give us an example of a high to low on a tuba?
Okay.
You guys are about to hear some loudness now. Right. That's a big instrument.
All right. It goes much lower, but you get the idea.
Yes.
And then high notes.
So now I got a treat for you. Check out Tuba Gooding Jr. from The Roots killing it on his tuba solo. Tuba Gooding Jr., here he is. That's exciting instrument. We have here.
Yes, sir.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, everybody knows a killer trombone here. And your name, sir?
My name is Mark Nagy.
All right, tell us a little bit about your horn.
Well, you know, it's got the slide, so you don't have to just play one note, you know. You know, you can do a little vibrato with the slide, which is nice.
Now, how about the range on a
trombone? Well, it's an octave higher than the tuba. You can go, but then you can go even lower than that. So that's like the lowest real note, and then you have false notes that go down. And then you got the pedals. That's the lowest, yeah.
What note is that?
That's a low B flat.
Wow.
Yeah, you don't really play down there too much, but you do play high a lot.
Right. So show something high, though.
High.
Just demonstrate a high note.
Oh, yeah. We also got... That's like the B flat, and you can go up to the... You can go up as high as you want. That's an F. And some guys can go, you know, up to that top B flat.
For my next exciting treat to you, there was a guy back in the day, a man named Tricky Sam Nanton. This is back in the early Duke Ellington days. He used to play trombone with Duke Ellington. He used to have a very particular tone. He was able to get this ya-ya sound, ya-ya-ya. Different than a wah-wah sound everybody else was getting, he had ya-ya. And it was super cool. He was the innovator. There were a few imitators, but he was the innovator, and this guy was crazy. So check out this solo off of Duke Ellington's Mood Indigo, Tricky Sam Nanton. Hey, we're here in Jambox Studio A. We have Dick Levine and his lovely wife, and we also have a very unique instrument that he plays called the concertina.
So the concertina was invented in 1832 by an English physicist, Charles Wheatstone. The accordion came about 10 years later, and the bandoneon, the instrument of the tango, came about 10 years after that. And the reason I mentioned the three is because they are the three major bellows instruments, the concertina, the accordion, and the bandoneon. You cannot go from one and play the other. They are very different, even though they are all bellows instruments. The accordion, of course, has a keyboard on the side. The bandoneon is the size of the accordion, but does not have a keyboard. And some of the notes you press play a full chord, some are single notes, and it's a different note when you push and pull. The concertina, each note is a single note, and whether you push or pull, the same note is being played.
Okay, folks, so that's going to wrap it up for us for episode 6 of the Jambox Show. Remember to tune in here weekly for our tips and tricks, news, reviews, and interviews, and so much more that you can use right here on the Jambox Show.